Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you 10 tips for homeschooling multiple children. If you're new to my channel, my name is Deanna and I'm a mom of four little ones. They are 10, 7, 5, and 2. And this year I'm homeschooling three of them. Here on my channel, I like to talk about my faith in Christ, homeschooling, and homemaking. So if that is interesting to you, I would love for you to subscribe to see my future videos. Be sure to stick around to the end of the video because tip number 10 is my favorite tip and one that I've utilized a lot this school year. But let's go ahead and dive in and I'll share with you my 10 tips for homeschooling multiple kids. All right, tip number one is to have a plan or a routine. And this seems very basic, but it's really important for you to know kind of the structure of your school day. I feel like kids especially thrive on a routine. So just having a basic framework to your day where your kids know, okay, I'm gonna wake up, I'm gonna have breakfast, you know, I'm gonna do chores, and then I'm gonna do school. Just having that structure to your school day will help lay the groundwork for your kids knowing, like, okay, it's school time, and being able to kind of switch gears and to get into school mode for the day. For our family, our kids know that after breakfast, around 9:30 or so, we are going to start with our morning basket, and that kind of starts off our school day. And so it just kind of helps them to transition into that school mindset so that we're all on the same page. All right, the second tip kind of goes along with tip number one, but tip number two is to plan ahead. This school year, I shared with you guys how I like to plan ahead for our coming week of homeschool, and I'll have that video linked in the description box below. Having everything planned and prepped and ready to go when the school week starts really has helped me to be able to jump in and for things to flow more smoothly. Especially when you have kids who are at different grade levels, say for math or handwriting or language arts, it's good to know if you need to make photocopies, if you need to have some kind of manipulatives ready to go. Just having everything prepped and ready to go saves me so much time. Okay. My third tip for homeschooling multiple kids is to allow your older kids to help with your younger ones. And so for our family, since we have four kids, this might look like asking my older daughter to play with my toddler for a few minutes while I work with my two middle kids on one of their subjects. And so just being able to kind of rotate in one of my older kids to play with my toddler for a few minutes while I'm working maybe with my kindergartner, that can be something that's helpful as well. Tip number four is if you have a baby, I feel like it's helpful to do school when your baby is napping. So typically when I have a small baby, they usually are having a morning nap and an afternoon nap. And so I would try to do school with my kids while my baby was napping in the morning. Being able to do school with the older kids while I have a napping baby has worked for us really well because it's usually a little bit quieter and there's fewer distractions and I'm able to focus more on the kids that I'm teaching. Tip number five is to choose curriculums that you can teach to multiple kids at different grade levels. So for our family, the group subjects that we have are science and history, as well as our Bible time. Anything that's in our morning basket, those are all group subjects. And so that has been really nice because I don't have a separate, you know, kindergarten science, and then a third grade science, and then a fifth grade science. Everyone does science, and then you can have each child do different activities based on their age and their capabilities. So being able to group the kids together on different subjects like that has been extremely helpful, and it also saves us money in not buying multiple curriculums. Great. Another thing to consider when teaching kids of multiple grade levels is to do unit studies. Unit studies are just a great way to incorporate multiple subjects all revolving around one theme. Unit studies are great because you can have all the kids work at their own level and also be incorporating multiple subject areas like math, art, history, geography, lots of things like that can be worked into a unit study. Tip number seven, I think, is really important, especially for first-time homeschoolers who might feel super overwhelmed with all the options for curriculum. In those early homeschool elementary years, it's okay to just focus on reading, writing, and math. Honestly, as long as you're laying a strong foundation for those three areas, then you can build off of that and do history and science as your kids get a little older. So for our family, when I had a preschooler and a kindergartner, I basically just focused on reading, writing, and math, and then we did something very light for science and history. I think we read through some simple picture books together. Being able to focus on reading, writing, and math really helps to take off some of that extra pressure as a new homeschool parent to just really dive into those three areas and then maybe do, you know, some picture books from the library for things like history and science. And that can make it a little bit more approachable, especially if you're going to be teaching kids of multiple grade levels. Tip number 8 for homeschooling multiple kids is to work towards independence. And for us, this has been really helpful as well. My oldest daughter is in 5th grade, and she's really to the point where she's able to read what her assignments are for the day. She's able to read the directions in her different workbooks. And for the most part, she's able to do almost all of her schoolwork independently. Unless, of course, she has questions on something, she's usually able to complete her work by herself. So definitely working with your older kids and encouraging them to be more independent in certain subject areas will free you up to work with younger kids while they're doing independent work. Tip number 9 for homeschooling kids of multiple grade levels is to utilize some technology, whether that be computer-based curriculum or maybe utilizing an iPad for some educational games. That can be a great way to kind of allow one child to be using a computer or a tablet while you're working with another one of your kids. Right now for our family, we do have an iPad and we have a spelling game that I mentioned in a previous video called Spelling City. We also have a piano app that connects to our keyboard and the kids are able to practice piano using that app. I also have some homeschooling friends who use teaching textbooks as their math curriculum, and it is a computer-based math program, and I know for them, they really have enjoyed it because it keeps track of all their children's grades and progress. Being able to utilize technology like computer-based learning or using an iPad is just another great way that you can kind of allow one of your kids to be learning through technology while you're helping maybe another younger child. And then my final tip, number 10, is using a split schedule. So if you have seen my homeschool routine video, I will link in the description box below. But basically for our family, what this looks like is I work with my youngest student first, my kindergartner. I work with her on her reading, her math, and her handwriting. And while I'm working with her on those subjects, my older two kids who are in 3rd and 5th grade are able to do their handwriting and math independently. And then when I'm done with my kindergartner, I switch and I work with my 3rd grader on his language arts and his reading because those are more teacher intensive subjects. After I work with my 3rd grader, then I work with my 5th grade daughter and I just kind of check her work for the day, make sure that she understood. If she has any questions, I can answer them. But that is kind of how I have split up our homeschool routine to work with each child individually. And so far this school year, it has worked really well for our first quarter. So I plan on continuing doing this split schedule for the rest of the school year. So that's going to be it for today's video. I hope that some of these tips will be helpful to you on your homeschooling journey. I'd love for you to comment below if you have any more tips for homeschooling multiple kids. Thanks as always for watching. I hope you guys have a great day. Bye.